Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Dennis Prager Show. All right, now, it isn't often. We have, by the way, just for your interest, I have in front of me every show on my computer screen. I have your name, your age. The age part is just for curiosity. I'm just as happy to have 9-year-olds as 90-year-olds. And I have no bias against age or for anything. I just want you to know. But I am curious. We have the city and state, and we have a summarization of what you want to say. But I will say this. It's pretty rare that the age is one digit. I would say I don't recall a three-digit age caller. And it's pretty rare we get a one-digit age caller. But we do have one now from New York City, Ahuva, who, according to this screen, is 9 years old. Is that correct, Ahuva? You are 9?
Yeah.
And you are calling because?
Because in regular fights or arguments, how do we know which side is right? Because we both think that.
All right, so you're asking, how do you know when you're having an argument who's right since both sides think they're right?
Or
right? Is that what you're asking?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. So now, sometimes there is no right. For example, if you say your favorite food, what is your favorite? Do you have a favorite food?
Yeah.
What is it?
Sushi.
My God. I have to say, when I was 9, I would not have said, I didn't know what sushi was. It's a different world. Okay. So let's say you are having an argument or a discussion with somebody. Oh, my favorite food, the best food is sushi. And the other person goes, are you kidding? The best food is pizza. Now, nobody's right. Is that clear? Because that's a matter of taste.
Right.
And taste cannot be right or wrong. But if somebody says, now I'll go to the other extreme. Somebody says, Columbus discovered America in 1492. And the other person says, no, it was 1592. Well, somebody is right and somebody is wrong, or they're both wrong, but they both cannot be right because the answer is a fact. In other words, there's a truth, and that's not opinion. That's the opposite of what is your favorite food. Is that clear? So
yeah.
In some cases, you simply know one of us we can't both be right because there is truth. And then you could look it up in a reputable place and then find out, well, by golly, Columbus came to America in 1492, not in 1592. Then there are other things where you have, do you have an example of an argument that you had that comes to mind?
When me and my sister have fights or arguments,
So given, do you remember any of the arguments? Is it over, go on.
I homeschool, so when one of us is working and the other one is practicing piano, we get annoyed at each other.
And you get annoyed about what? That you're not working, you're playing piano, or
no, that you're trying to work and someone's playing piano.
Oh, you mean the piano is disturbing the person who's working?
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Well, is there since you can't move the piano, can the person who's not playing the piano go into another room?
Yeah.
Why doesn't that solve the problem?
It does, but at that moment, we both think we're right.
Right, but that's not true, because since you can't move the piano, it would seem to me that the one who's complaining about the piano playing is wrong. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Always ask, here is the key, always ask what is right, not am I right. Then you will live a great, great life. Ask what is right, not am I right. Okay?
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. What a joy. What a joy.